Good morning and welcome to morning prayer here at the Washington National Cathedral. My name is Anne Ratonia. I'm the 8th Bishop of Episcopal Armed Forces and Federal Ministries, and it is a delight to be here with you this morning. Today we pray morning prayer commemorating Katharina von Bora, and we also celebrate the 4th birthday of the United States Space Force. The Space Force was established in 2019 with organizational agility, innovation, and boldness as its hallmarks. Space Force Guardians' core values of character, commitment, connection, and courage shape each member of the Space Force and help ensure the United States maintains space superiority required to protect us against hostile attacks, and incorporating space power into military strategy. Happy birthday, Guardians. And now I invite you to join me in prayer. The glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. Our King and Savior draws near. Come, let us adore him. The appointed psalm for today is Psalm 46. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth be moved, and though the mountains be toppled into the depths of the sea, though its waters rage in foam, and though the mountains tremble at its tumult. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of her, and she shall not be overthrown. God shall help her at the break of day. The nations make much ado, and the kingdoms are shaken. God has spoken, and the earth shall melt away. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Come now and look upon the works of the Lord. What awesome things God has done on earth. It is he who makes the war to cease in all the world. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear and burns the shields with fire. Be still then, and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The appointed reading for today is from the 15th chapter of John's Gospel, verses 1 through 11. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He removes every branch in me that bears no fruit. Every branch that bears fruit, he prunes to make it bear more fruit. You already have been cleansed by the word that I have spoken to you. Abide in me as I abide in you. Just as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine and you are the branches, and those who abide in me and I in them bear much fruit, because apart from me you can do nothing. Whoever does not abide in me is thrown away like a branch and withers. Such branches are gathered, thrown into the fire and burned. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask for whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. My Father is glorified by this, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Have you ever found yourself in a situation that was overwhelming and in the present moment felt helpless? For those in our federal prisons and VA hospitals especially, these feelings are not that uncommon. And our federal ministry chaplains are there to remind those they care for of God's love and guide them in ways that can lead them to healing and hope. Guided by Jesus, our chaplains remind those they care for that they are not alone, that they are loved. And while the present may be painful, there is hope for joy, a joy-filled future, and even joy in the midst of suffering. And our scripture today speaks to that as well. As Jesus is preparing his disciples for his departure, and he wants to assure them of his presence, even and especially when life gets hard. And he reminds them if they keep God's command and they love one another as he loved them, they will not only abide in him, but he will abide in them. He will be in them. He will be with them. And for John's community who first heard this gospel, they were facing pretty hard times. Many in that community had been rejected by their families, by their friends, by the faith communities that they had known all their lives in order to follow Jesus. And so John's retelling of Jesus' final words of comfort offered them a different lens to view their own experiences of loss. Loss would not have the final word. Jesus is with you, abiding with you, holding on to you, enduring with you, loving you, and will not let go no matter what. God's care is constant and reliable. And if you stick close to the vine, you will eventually find joy. Maybe not today, maybe not tomorrow, but joy will come. And for those of you that are listening to our prayer this morning, who may be hurting or struggling, I encourage you to seek out a loving community like one here at the cathedral, where you can find support and care and love. Friends, we are not meant to do life alone, and our joy is not dependent on our success as the world might define it, but rather on the quality of our relationships, our relationship with God and with one another. Relationships characterized by interdependence, mutual respect, and the ongoing presence of Christ. I am so grateful for our chaplains who care for members of our armed forces, our veterans, and the incarcerated, reminding them that they are not alone, that they are loved, that their lives matter, and that they can make a difference in the world, especially when they stay close to the source of all love. And our chaplains can provide tools to help those they serve find that space of love. Friends, life can be hard, but we can make it more bearable when we abide in God's love, especially with one another. And so today, I encourage you to share that love with someone who is hurting or isolated or suffering in a kind word, a visit, a bag of groceries, or even just a smile. I know the meaning and purpose you will discover is going to draw you even closer to the source of that love. And now, I invite you to join me in the prayer that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. And now let us pray. Almighty God, who called Katerina von Bora from a cloister to work for the reform of your church, grant that all of us may go wherever you call and serve however you will for your honor and glory and for the welfare of your whole church. All this we ask through Jesus Christ, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. And a prayer for the Space Force. Creator and loving God, today we gather to offer you thanks and praise for the many ways that you love and protect us. We thank you for the men and women of the United States Space Force. Watch over them, we pray, as they protect our country and the freedom to operate in space, keeping it secure, stable, and accessible for our national security. Grant them courage, knowledge, and skill, and fill them with a grateful sense of your mercy. And in all things, may they serve you without reproach through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. To prayer for peace. O God, the author of peace and lover of concord, to know you is eternal life and to serve you is perfect freedom. Defend us, your humble servants, we pray, in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in your defense, may not fear the power of any adversaries through the might of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And to prayer for mission. O God, you have made of one blood all the peoples of the earth and sent your blessed Son to preach peace to those who are far off and to those who are near. Grant that people everywhere may seek after you and find you and bring the nations into your fold. Pour out your Spirit upon all flesh and hasten the coming of your kingdom through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now I invite your prayers and petitions in this short time of silence. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Thank you for joining me for morning prayer today, and may God bless you and keep you in this season of Advent.